To tie the deep sparkling pupa, the hook I have on the vise is a size 14 and it's a standard wet fly nymph hook. And to weigh the fly down, I'm going to use some lead wire, 15 thousandths. And I definitely want this fly on the bottom of the river, you know, stream, river, lake, whatever. It definitely needs to be at the bottom, bouncing. So I'm going to wrap some lead wraps, mainly to cover the whole hook chain, just about. Most of it, anyway. And for the thread, Danville's Flymaster, black. And I'm just going to start that directly behind the eye. Hold the lead wraps with my finger. And get it started on the lead wire. Wrap it back. Wrap a few times behind the lead. Wrap the lead some more. I'm going to bring it back two-thirds of the way up the hook shank. I'll just remove the tag end from the back. And then for the overbody, I have some olive antron yarn. And this yarn, let's see, it's actually sparkle yarn, it's olive, and it comes on a card, and it's got three segments to it. Each, the yarn itself has three of these segments on it, wound together. So I'm just going to go ahead and clip that to clean that end up so I can bind it down. Go ahead and bind that down. And I'm going to pick it out right now. With the antron yarn, it's like, oh, somebody's long, thick hair that's been matted down for a while. It needs to be picked out. It knots up. So I'm going to take that, hold all that stuff downward. I have it separated in two sections, so I'm going to hold each section down as I wind it towards the back. And for the underbody, I'm going to use some, I don't know if you can pick it up on the camera, it's dark olive, and it's mottled nymph blend dubbing, and I'm just going to dub that on. Let's see where that takes me. There we go. Now I'm just going to take the antron yarn and pull it forward. I'm going to pull it tight and then I'm going to bubble it out. Before I tighten it down, I'm going to take a look around the whole hook. As long as it's relatively got the the hook encased, and you got a good bubble there. You can bind that down. You know what, I better spin my bobbin counterclockwise, that way it jumps back. Oh, I better just trim this. I'll trim this stuff here, make it easier on me. Sandtron, the yarn's kind of slick. Definitely wants to creep on you. I'll just go ahead and remove the waste. Now I'm going to clean all that up, bind it all in. Trim some of this stuff. And then for the wing, to get your leg effect and your antenna effect, I'm just going to use some partridge feathers. Or a partridge feather. I'm just going to go ahead and clean up all this stuff here. Remove all the fluff. You definitely want to be left with a smallish feather. You don't want too much fibers around it. So I'm just going to pinch the tip of the partridge feather, pull all that stuff back, trim that tip. Attach the feather. I'm just going to wind it on. Try to get as many turns as I can. Looks like two turns, or that was maybe one. Didn't get too many out of it. Enough though. We'll secure the stem. Pull this stuff going forward, pull it back. Wrap back on the partridge. I caught some here. I'm going to go ahead and trim those. There we go. And if you're happy with that, that's fine. And then to clean up the head and form a head, a buggy, nymphy head, I'm going to use some black rabbit dubbing. Not much, just enough to make a head, form a head. I'm going to go ahead and wax my string. Four or five turn whip finish is sufficient. Make sure it's all pulled tight. Trim the thread. And there it is. Deep sparkling pupa. Hope you've enjoyed watching. I appreciate you watching. And I'll talk to you soon.